It was such a... Though Evgeny was born in Soviet Union 25 years after me, I think it's the same situation with Jews and their efforts to make career as in my times. So I saw this story in the beginning as a very simple one. In every Jewish family, mother says to her son that because you're Jewish and because of discrimination and because of anti-Semitism, you must be number one. You must be the best in physics or in chess and music. And so there are children who listen to their mothers more and those who listen less. And Evgeny, as I thought, definitely was very obeying son. He listened to his mother and he succeeded. But today when I met his mother, she destroyed all my story. She told me that she couldn't tell him anything. In the age of 11 months, I say, I understand correctly, in the age of 11 months, he started listening to music, repeating music, singing music, writing music, and later playing music. So she had no say in this. It had nothing to do with anti-Semitism or with anything else. It was simply, he went to the world of music and nobody could stop him and take him from this. I asked today, Evgeny, how many times you were champion in Tchaikovsky competition? Because everybody who was born Soviet Union knows that there is no way that you become an outstanding musician without it. And he said, I never in my life participated in any competitions. Because he, from the early age, from the age of two, he became already above all competition. So, but even though he is, he didn't have to overcome these problems of anti-Semitism. As every young Jew, he had to face two major questions or challenges. When he was in Russia, definitely when he moved to New York, and when he was settled in London, in Paris. And these two questions which young Jews all over the world have to answer and are facing them. And the more talented, the more successful professional they are, the more pressing is the need to answer these questions. First is, why to stay with Israel, with this shtetl, with this tribe? You are crossing the borders of all the world. You are men of the letters, of the sounds. You belong to the world of great universal ideas. Why to insist on your on belonging to your tribe? And if at any moment young Jew believes that he has to choose between being the person of one nation or the person of the world, he always will choose to be the person of the world, because that's in the blood of our Jewishness. All the idea of Jewishness is the one God, one moral code, in the image of God created every person, and that's it. The fact that the choice is wrong, that you don't have to choose, you have to understand it, you have to feel it. And the second question is, because of this big wave of new anti-Semitism, which all directed towards Israel, so many young Jews feel that they have to disconnect themselves from Israel. Why to be connected to Israel? As I heard again and again, it's so bad for our career. It's so bad for our relations with our friends. Why to be connected to Israel? And because we, as Jewish agency, is facing this problem all over the world, all our thousands of shlichim and marim and rabbis and social leaders, they have to deal with this question, how to explain to young generation why to be connected to Jews doesn't mean to leave the bigger world, and why to be connected to Israel. You can imagine how I was excited when a year ago I received a request for citizenship and this statement of Evgeny Kissin. And I want to read all the statement and think about these two big questions. Evgeny was writing a year ago, I am a Jew, Israel is a Jewish state, and since long ago I have felt that Israel, although I don't live there, is the only state in the world with which I can fully identify myself, whose case, problems, tragedies, and very destiny I perceive to be mine. If I, as a human being and artist, represent anything in the world, it is my Jewish people, and therefore Israel is the only state on our planet which I want to represent with my art and all my public activities, no matter where I live. When Israel's enemies try to disrupt concerts of Israel Philharmonic Orchestra or the Jerusalem Quartet, I want them to come and make troubles at my concerts too, because Israel's case is my case. Israel's enemies are my enemies, and I don't want to be spared of the troubles which Israeli musicians encounter when they represent the Jewish state beyond its borders. I have always deeply despised chauvinism and have never regarded my people to be superior to other peoples. I feel truly blessed that my profession is probably the most international one in the world, that I play music created by great composers of different countries, that I travel all over the world and share my beloved music with people of different countries and nationalities. But I want all the people who appreciate my art to know that I am a Jew, that I belong to the people of Israel. That's why now I feel a natural desire to travel around the world with an Israeli passport. Ladies and gentlemen, now I want the Minister of Aliyah and Absorption, Sofa Landwehr, in the name of Israeli government, to give to Evgeny Kissin Israeli passport.
כן, מגיע לא מחיות כפיים ומגיע לדרכונים שהוא מקבל, לדרכון, לתעודת עולה ותעודת זהות. אני חושבת שאנחנו מתרגשים כולנו יחד. אנחנו מתרגשים היום ממש, בגלל שזה פסנתרן אחד מהכי גדולים שיש היום בעולם. אני חושבת שכאשר הוא היום יעלה על במות של העולם וינגן, אנחנו נדע שישראלי מנגן שם ושייכות לישראל. הוא איש גדול. הוא תמיד היה יהודי ותמיד יישאר יהודי, אבל היום להשם של יהודי אנחנו מוסיפים יהודי ישראלי. ברכות לו.
Say something regarding one of the points Nathan has just raised, the question for young Jews who lived outside Israel, why remain with my people, why remain with Israel? I could reply to that with Shakespeare's famous words, "To thine own self be true." I could recall a stanza from a poem by the famous Russian poet Nikolai Zabolotsky. All right, I'll say it in Russian. Пусть непрочны домашние стены, пусть дорога уводит во тьму, нет на свете печальней измены, чем измена себе самому. Which means, even though the walls of our home are yes, shaky, even though our way may lead to darkness, there is no sadder betrayal in the world than betrayal of oneself. And I can also remember the famous words of Rabbi Zusse of Anapelka. When I die and appear in front of Hashem, He will not ask me why in hard times were you not Abraham or Moses. He will ask me why were you not Rabbi Zusev. A few minutes ago, the journalist from Yisrael Hayom asked me how I felt tonight on this occasion. I replied, I feel elated. Why? The gentleman asked me. And I thought, indeed, why? And after thinking for a few seconds, I gave the following reply. Now, becoming an Israeli, I feel more in harmony with myself, in my soul. It just feels more natural for me, because I have cared about Israel virtually my whole adult life. A few years ago, there came a point in my life when I felt that I simply could no longer continue giving concerts and enjoying my success all over the world and keep silent about the growing prejudice and hatred towards Israel all over the Western world. The prejudice and hatred which were the result of the cunning propaganda war waged by Israel's enemies. That's why I started speaking out in defense of Israel, sent a letter to the director general of the BBC protesting against their anti-Israel bias, started speaking out in support of Israel in my interviews in various countries, began publishing pro-Israel materials on my fan club site. And then I felt, but which country do I actually represent? Which country can I fully identify myself, no matter where I live? As I wrote in the letter Nathan quoted a few minutes ago, and my only answer to that question was Israel. And an overwhelming majority of my Jewish friends and acquaintances who live in the diaspora think and feel the same way. That's why I would like to use this occasion to appeal to other Jews who live in the diaspora to join my example. Where each person chooses to live is his or her personal business. We all have various reasons for that. But let's not give our enemies a pretext to accuse us of hypocrisy, of double loyalties, of hinterland patriotism. If Israel is so dear to us, no matter where we live, let's be Israeli. אני איתך, מדינת ישראל, אני איתכם, העם שלי. עכשיו, אני יכול להגיד לכל עולם, לא רק אני יהודי, אך גם אני ישראלי. וזה כבוד ומזל גדול. תודה.
Before we'll sing Hatikva, because that's exactly the kind of thing, I only want to say that it was not a traditional move, and it needed some non-traditional decisions over the number of ministers. And I want, on this opportunity, to thank Dan Miridor and Eli Shai from the previous government, and Itzhak Aronovich, and of course, Gideon Sar, and of course, Sofa Landwehr, without whose cooperation nothing could happen. And behind every minister, there is a team of professionals. So Lior Shachar from Ministry of Interior was extremely important. Boris Elliman, who did it so quickly and effectively. And very outstanding team from Jewish Agency, Jacques Korkus, Josh Schwartz, and Vera Golovensky, only a few of them. Thank you.
Thank you. Many heartfelt thanks to you all.
Thank you.
Many most. United with Banner.